Folks, can you see it all? I'll see it. You can't. It's not an eye test. You can just see it. Okay. All right, thank you. Right, Jesse. Owen, your French is oh so fun. And she says, by any chance, were you using anything tonight? Now they are communicating on Facebook. Oh, I'm sorry. This is further conversation that occurred before they got together, where they're just I have dinner from 7 to 9. I also have a dinner then, but the rest of my night is pretty clear. Golden. A little crazy for the tower. And Owen says, but I can take you somewhere else that's pretty sweet. And then the rest of it is logistics. And let me just get oriented here. This continues to be just the logistics. But I just want to show you that you're going to have all of this to see. Jesse, where should we meet? Oh, you pick. I'm in your hands. Oh, ah. Why don't I meet you outside the school? So these are the logistical emails. They're down to here. And then we're back to the events after the day. Jesse appears to have been unwilling during the date. You have the ability to draw the inferences by looking at these words. Remember the last question was, did you have something? Like a condom? Yeah. Aha. Okay. Thanks. Now, I don't know how many of you are regular texters, whether you know what ha 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 means. Are you on the pill? Nope. Oh, praise Jesus, I put it on like halfway through. Okay. Yeah, I think you're fine. Hopefully, you know for sure that before or after you came, says, it's all good. Thanks. Owen to her. You're a gem. Let me know if there's anything I can do. Not too bad to yourself. I will. I also lost my earring up there. This is an obscenity, like crap. Life is hard. Yes. Ha ha ha. The prose of French. Owen, I adore you. Good. Jesse. Ah. More French. Coquin, which means tease. They say, tease? Me? Never. Oh, truly. Also, these were my favorite pair of earrings. Does this sound like texting where she was unwilling that night? Where the prosecutor is going to be able to show by these words that very night that these are the words of a rape victim? Was that night before anybody found out that they had been together. This will be, you have to deduct 4 hours to get Eastern time where we are. So this is actually at 1 a.m. In regard to the earrings, I can check if they made it into my bag. Or we can check tomorrow. Thank you, Owen. He writes back, for you it is nothing. Thank you very much. What are you up to this late? Ha ha ha. Insomnia mostly.
Third form insomnia? Tragedy. I know. I'll probably get some rest now. Golden. Have happy dreams. And you. Oh. And that's where the exchanges end. For that night. Her own words. No force. No compulsion. She's in her room. He's in his room. She's typing all of these words. That will be the, I submit, the most important evidence on that issue. About whether she was an unwilling participant in what happened that night. In other words, whether she was a rape victim or whether she was a willing participant. And that will apply to all of the charges that allege that what happened was not with her consent. Let me talk about the second issue. The second issue that you have to decide, based on the evidence that will be introduced at this trial, will be whether Owen inserted his penis, his finger, or his tongue into her vagina. Now, the prosecutor is relying greatly on the concept of the senior salute.
The senior salute, as you found out, is a tradition at St. Paul's. A tradition that the evidence will show has gone on for decades at this school. Decades. And a senior salute is not something that Owen came up with on his own, nor did the other boys and girls at the school come up with on their own. This was something that indeed did have happened in the spring. You'll also hear, as the prosecutor confirmed, that a senior salute could mean kissing and hugging. And if a senior kissed and hugged a freshman or a sophomore or a junior, that constituted a senior salute. I believe everybody who talks about the senior salute will indicate that. So the fact that there was a senior salute, or that there was a competition to see how many people could have a senior salute, people competing to say, how many girls can I have kiss me, or hug me, or be with me? Because if that girl did that, then the boy was making a senior salute. And you'll also hear evidence that the girls would be honored and proud about this, that they were the focus of a senior salute, that a senior had thought that this girl was pretty enough, or interesting enough, or just an acquaintance enough to be the subject of a senior salute. Everybody is getting all worked up about the senior salute. But when you know that it has that range of activity, and senior salute gets you only a tiny step closer. Because what you have to decide is what happened, as she's stating today. But you'll have evidence of her words that night as well. Because Owen has stated from the outset, when he was interviewed by the police, and what he'll testify to at this trial, that he did not have sexual intercourse with his penis, his tongue, or his finger with her that night. The defendant has a right not to testify. And you all told the judge you would not hold it against him if he did not. But I'm informing you, Owen has told me he is going to testify in this trial. He's going to take that witness stand and testify what happened, and be subject to the prosecutor's cross-examination. So you will be able to hear from him directly, because he wants to tell you. He will say what he told when he was interviewed by the police. Because early on, the police got involved in this case. And when the police got involved, they called him and asked him, I have to keep cognizant of this. I feel like Dr. Phil if I walk around with this. No joke.
I think this would be easier.
Okay.
And you don't have to worry about
moving
anything.
Right. Thank you. Let me tell you how the police handled this. They called Owen. They couldn't reach him. They called his mother and said they needed to speak to Owen. Owen was in Maine with friends. So he called the police. The detective, Julie Curtin, spoke to him. A date, yes, a senior salute. They got together, they kissed, they hugged, but there was no sexual intercourse, whether by cunnilingus, insertion of a penis, anyway. And the detective said, well, look, I want to hear from you in person. So the next day, Owen went to Carney and told the police officer, I'm ready to speak to you in person. I'm at the True Brew Cafe. And the detective showed up, surprised to see that Owen was with his mother. The detective also brought another detective with her. Owen and his mother were surprised that it'd be two people speaking to Owen. But Owen said, I'm willing to speak to you about everything. But the police wanted to gain an advantage. They wanted to get him back to the Concord police station. They didn't want to talk to Owen in a public place. So Owen and his mom went to the police station. His mom told the police that they had been advised that Owen should be accompanied by an attorney. And the police said, oh, this is just a preliminary inquiry. You don't have to have a lawyer with you. And they went back to the police station. When they got to the police station, the next step for the police, according to the book, separate the target from his mother. And said, you know, it'd be better if your mom wasn't with you when we talked to you. Mom was there with a pad and pen, ready to record what was said. They said, no, better that you stay down here, Mom. We'll take him upstairs. They brought him upstairs, brought him into a room, and the environment changed, as you will hear. The pad got slammed. How long did they question this person who was in high school up until a couple of weeks before this? How long was he in that room being questioned by the police? A situation he had never encountered before in his life? 3 hours and 45 minutes. And then he was brought downstairs and returned to his mother. And the reason that's significant is with all the techniques, all the ability, all of, frankly, the tricks used to try to get him to admit his guilt, Owen kept repeating over and over to the police about what he had done. As Owen will tell you, the exact same thing. They had kissed. They had petted. He had, forgive me for this phrase, dry humped her, which is a man clothed on top of a female, clothed and going up and down, or vice versa. The evidence in this case will show that Owen's boxers never came off. Obviously pleased, using the phrases that the government used, laughing, giggling. She wanted to have sex with him. He walked over to his pants and put on a condom. And he walked back. And he'll tell you, as he told the police, he realized at that moment that that's not what he should do. And he told them, let's just get on our
evidence will show is that they never did have sex. There was a lot of dry humping, no question about that. And dry humping sometimes is a point, to the point of ejaculation by a guy, or embarrassingly a pre-ejaculation, a premature ejaculation, or a discharge of some semen. But Owen made the decision after he put on a condom that he was not going to go forward with this. And that's what the evidence will show you. Owen Labrie, senior in high school. Let me just tell you a little bit about him. He grew up in a small town in Vermont. He had been born in Lebanon, but then they moved over the border. His parents got divorced when he was two, and he lived with his mother throughout growing up. And you'll hear testimony about that. She works as a school teacher in Vermont. There was no way he could ever afford to go to St. Paul's School, given the family income. But he was offered a scholarship and made the most of it. He was an excellent student. He participated in a lot of activities at the school. He was the prefect in the chapel and got to know the clergy there, because Owen had intends to go to divinity school, amazing college. He was also active in sports. Yes, he was popular. Yes, he'd be quite a catch for a freshman to get a senior salute from Owen. But Owen is not someone who did this crime. And I submit to you that at the end of this case, when you've seen the whole evidence, had a chance to study these emails and text messages, and you've had a chance to hear from Owen himself, you will see that the evidence leaves you with a feeling that you have a reasonable doubt about what happened. And that given this evidence, that reasonable doubt should compel you to return a verdict of not guilty. Thank you very much.
That's a good approach.
I've been talking to council about the logistics, because it is called 10. We want you to be concentrating on the evidence and how busy you are. So we are going to take a lunch break and then start immediately with review after lunch. I remind you, please do not discuss this case either among yourselves or with anyone else. Please do not read this or watch any press coverage, and please engage in that with independent research. I'll be saying that a lot, and I'll say it not vocally, but because it's important. And we will see you in 1 hour, which is, it is 12:10 now, I promise a little fast, so be here at 1:10.
All ready, please?
Carol, thank you for asking for my
Beautiful.
Oh, you're
Very good, thank you very much.
Good.
But I can take you somewhere else that's pretty sweet. And then the rest of it is logistics. And let me just get oriented here. This continues to be just the logistics. But I just want to show you that you're going to have all of this to see. Jesse, where should we meet? Owen, you pick. I'm in your hands. Owen, why don't I meet you outside the school? So these are the logistical emails. They're down to here. And then we're back to the events after the day. Jesse appears to have been unwilling during the day. You have the ability to draw the inferences by looking at these words. Remember the last question was, did you have something? Like a condom? Yeah. Aha. Okay, thanks. Now, I don't know how many of you are regular texters, whether you know what ha 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 means. Are you on the pill? praise Jesus, I put it on like halfway through. Okay. Yeah, I think you're fine. Hopefully. You know for sure? Before or after you came? Folks, can you see it all? Oh, I'll see it. You can't. It's not an eye test. You can just see it. Okay. All right. Thank you. Writes Jesse. Owen, your French is oh so fun. And she says, by any chance, were you using anything tonight? Now they are communicating on Facebook. Oh, I'm sorry. This is further conversation that occurred before they got together, where they're just I have dinner from 7 to 9. I also have a dinner then, but the rest of my night is pretty clear. Golden. A little crazy for the tower. And Owen says, it's all good. Thanks. Owen to her. You're a gem. Let me know if there's anything I can do. Not too bad yourself. I will. I also lost my earring up there. Uh-huh. This is an obscenity. Like crap. Life is hard. Yes. Ha ha ha. The pros of French. Owen. I adore you. Good. Jesse. Ah. More French. Spokane, which means tease. And they say, tease? Me? Never. Oh, truly. Also, these were my favorite pair of earrings. Does this sound like texting? Where she was unwilling that night? Where the prosecutor is going to be able to show by these words that very night that these are the words of a rape victim? Will be you have to deduct 4 hours to get Eastern time where we are. So this is actually at 1 a.m. And with regard to the earrings, I can check if they made it into my bag. Or we can check tomorrow. Thank you, Owen. He writes back, for you it is nothing. Thank you very much. What are you up to this late? Ha ha ha, and hugging. And if a senior kissed and hugged a freshman, or a sophomore, or a junior, that constituted a senior salute. I believe everybody who talks about the senior salute will indicate that. So the fact that there was a senior salute, or that there was a competition to see how many people could have a senior salute, people competing to say, how many girls can I have kiss me or hug me or be with me? Because if that girl did that, then the boy was making a senior salute. And you'll also hear evidence that the girls would be honored and proud about this, that they were the focus of a senior salute. That a senior had thought that this girl was pretty enough, or interesting enough, or just an acquaintance enough to be the subject of a senior salute. Everybody is getting all worked up about the senior salute. But when you know that it has that range of activity, then senior salute gets you only a tiny step closer. Because what you have to decide is what happened, as she's stating today. But you'll have evidence of her words that night as well. Because Owen has stated from the outset, when he was interviewed by the police, and what he'll testify to at this trial, that he did not have sexual intercourse with his penis, his tongue, or his finger with her that night. The defendant has a right not to testify. And you all told the judge you would not hold it against him if he did not. But I'm informing you, Owen has told me he is going to testify in this trial. He's going to take that witness stand and testify what happened and be subject to the prosecutor's cross-examination. So you will be able to hear from him directly because he wants to tell you. He will say what he told when he was interviewed by the police. Because early on, the police got involved in insomnia mostly.
Third form insomnia? Tragedy. I know. I'll probably get some rest now. Golden. Have happy dreams. And you, Owen. And that's where the exchanges end for that night. Her own words. No force. No compulsion. She's in her room. He's in his room. She's typing all of these words. That will be the, I submit, the most important evidence on that issue about whether she was an unwilling participant in what happened that night. In other words, whether she was a rape victim or whether she was a willing participant. And that will apply to all of the charges that allege that what happened was not with her consent. Let me talk about the second issue. The second issue that you have to decide, based on the evidence that will be introduced at this trial, will be whether Owen inserted his penis, his finger, or his tongue into her vagina. Now, the prosecutor is relying greatly on the concept of the senior salute. The senior salute, as you found out, is a tradition at St. Paul's School. A tradition that the evidence will show has gone on for decades at this school. Decades. And a senior salute is not something that Owen came up with on his own. Nor did the other boys and girls at the school come up with on their own. This was something that indeed did have happened in the spring. You'll also hear, as the prosecutor confirmed, that a senior salute could mean kissing.